Welcome to Streaming Deluxe. My name is Mr. Orange and welcome to a new video. And in this video I'm going to talk about the stocks of the most popular gaming companies. So this is I already made a lot of those videos in my last 1,000 videos on my YouTube channel. So for some of you this might be new, but just listen to this video and you're going to learn a lot, and I'm also going to tell you a lot that will help you guys in your life. So, but a little disclaimer before I continue, I'm not a financial advisor, I'm just a YouTuber. Please don't buy anything I'm talking here about. Those are no recommendations. So you just, if you trade, if you buy something, if you sell something, it's on your own responsibility. So this is just for information and entertainment purpose only. So yeah, those disclaimers are necessary. So we have to bring those disclaimers, that's for sure. All right, so my friend, so let's go very quickly before I continue with those stocks, go back to my YouTube channel. So you see here I have a Fall Guys giveaway going on, so check out this video. It's the last video, it's my 1,000th video, and I promise you, you can win a Fall Guys Steam key. So make sure to comment, like this video, and also subscribe to my channel. And of course, I'm also doing, as you can see here, I'm also doing a lot of Steam key hunts. So I'm now using two question marks, not in case that any bots are going to try the whole alphabet through and then the keys are claimed too fast. So now two question marks, and then you always find them somewhere here on my video. So for example, I put it here on this video in the arena booth, the question marks, and then you have to find it. So that's my Steam key hunt. And then also some people ask me, oh, is this legit? Is it legit to win a Fall Guys Steam key? Yeah, honestly, I'm making here a Steam key giveaway since now, like an eternity, since 2 months. I'm giving away Steam keys and everyone got his Steam keys for now. So it's absolutely 100% legit, obviously. So a lot of people already won twice, got two keys. So yeah, what shall I say? I'm just laughing about comments like this. Okay, but we will want to also continue my random sticky giveaway comment picker. So here it's the wrong video in. So what video shall we take? So I don't do it now with the Fall Guys Steam key, since this is for in the end of the next week when we have a lot of comments and views there. So I think I'm choosing just again the last one. So everyone that commented the last one has a chance to again to win. So that's awesome. Oh, look, I see an ad. So let's take the last video. The last video is Steam versus Epic Weekend, and I'm copying it in. And you see filter duplicate users, include replies to comments. Yeah, of course they are in. Filter comments based on specific tags, add extra entries, exclude blacklist users. I don't have any blacklisted users yet, but I also want to say here again, if you try to scam me by just sending me an email that you won, no, I'm going to blacklist you in the future. So guys, don't try to scam me, don't try it. I'm always asking you to send me your email the email has to be the same email that you used to comment on YouTube, otherwise you're not getting a key. So that's very important. All right, so get YouTube comments. So 120, this was a very successful 120 unique comments, and now we start the raffle. The winner is Samu Maestrul Eccentric Shaolin Din Templu. Hehe, you have more comments than visualizations. Yeah, this is funny because someone was spamming. So spamming doesn't help. One comment only counts. Okay, so let's go back. I want to talk, really want to talk about this, because that's another of my hobbies I would say trading, investing. In the stock market, especially in gaming companies. So I really love this subject a lot. Therefore, I want to continue talking about this. So we already lost now so much time with the random comment picker. So, but then this video is going to be a bit longer. All right, so this is the NASDAQ Composite. And the NASA Composite is an index for those of you that are new. So mostly tech stocks are listed here. So you can see, oh my God. So it was actually going very well in the last 20 years. Oh my God, since the dot-com bubble. So where are we standing now? Let's say in the last 3 weeks, 3 months. So we had a low to 10,540 points, and now we came back very nicely from this low. We're not back at the all-time high. So for example, stocks like Tesla, etc., trade in the Nasdaq. So we're not back at the all-time high. So I would be a little bit cautious. Okay. Gaming stock. The first gaming stock is Activision Blizzard, and Activision Blizzard didn't manage really to keep it up over the all-time high at around about $85. So that's it's kind of sad. So, but disclaimer: I'm invested in Activision, so it didn't really manage to stay there. So, but yeah, I hope the best that they continue, because when I look in the long run, so Activision Blizzard always was doing quite nicely. So, but it's also stock where you sometimes need to just take your gains and get in back when they are lower again. Ah yeah, and the new Call of Duty is coming out. Let's see if the new Call of Duty is actually giving it a push. Nintendo, oh my God, guys, what the lockdowns and all of the shit. Sorry for my words, so I should make a beep over this. So Nintendo really managed to get like crazy up. So I'm not invested in Nintendo. I always say, yeah, I didn't invest in Nintendo. I'm actually not so convinced, but they since very long time, since years, since over 100 years, they're doing quite well with their products. So a new Switch, I think, is coming out, and yeah, for the rest, a lot of games. Then we have Electronic Arts, came nicely back. I like EA Play on Steam, I really like this. So they bring new FIFA games, new NHL games. Is there anything more interesting on the horizon of Electronic Arts? I don't see any interesting games there. I don't know how it is for you guys, but I don't see anything interesting. So I guess it's quite fair that they're actually trading a little bit sideways here. Would I go in? I don't know. I mean, they would get punished a lot if the Nasdaq would fall again. Take-Two Interactive, Red Dead Redemption, GTA 5 are the games. So they have a very good online model with microtransactions. So they make a lot of cash, a lot of money. So, but they definitely need a GTA 6. Is a GTA 6 on the horizon? I have actually no idea if it. I think it was announced. So probably when it's going to be announced, we will see a nice upticked from here. But for now, I would also be a bit more cautious with Take-Two Interactive. Then we have Ubisoft trading sideways, having a lot of social problems in the company. So a lot of managers were leaving. So my God, can they not just concentrate on the games? Can they not concentrate on the games? Why are they have so many issues? Unbelievable. So trading nicely up again. I mean, from the low of 66 up to 82 when was the low in April. So also pretty nice how Ubisoft might start a comeback. Also the new games that are on the horizon, Valhalla. So it's not Valhalla Hills, it's Assassin's Creed Valhalla. So some nice games are coming, but the quality of the games suffered recently, so they have to do more. And this is, I mean, look, this is a flag. This is called a flag. When it just goes that steep up, and it's just crazy because no normal person would purchase then now here. So who would purchase it? I mean, honestly, guys, this comes back. So don't buy Capcom. Definitely not. I mean, this is simply crazy. I mean, look at this up, at this gap. This is called a gap when you see then from one. From one candle to the next one, you see such a gap. That's called a gap. So crazy. I wouldn't invest a single dollar in this. Then we have CD Projekt. What's going on with CD Projekt? Guys, oh my God. I think the market starts to understand the problem with CD Projekt. In my personal opinion, it's like 1-2 games company. I say it each time. Cyberpunk 2077 is coming out, and after this we will see a massive drop, I think, in CD Projekt. Maybe that's then a good opportunity to get in, why not? But for now, I would say, guys, yeah, I mean, why is CD Projekt now falling? So, in the, that's the Polish zloty, it's a Polish currency. Maybe Witcher 4. The moment they announce Witcher 4, I mean, then we can definitely see some nice upturn. But Cyberpunk 2077 is like priced in, so it means it's expected that the game is going to be awesome and it's going to come. Like since 2018, so since then it doubled. So I don't know if they can live up to the hype. Mostly new games don't live up to the hype. Even Cyberpunk 2077, I don't expect to live up to the hype. Then Zynga mobile phone games. You know, say, I don't like mobile phone games. I'm a PC gamer, Mr. Orange. Why talk about mobile phone games? You're a noob. Yeah. But I'm just talking about the stock, and I mean, someone was quadrupling his money with mobile phone game company. I'm just putting it like this. Tencent Holdings is having a little comeback with 2%, so again at $70. Oh my god, I didn't see this. And I'm not invested anymore, so I sold it. At one point, I think at $68, I sold Tencent, so I'm not invested anymore. Of course, I mean, can we see a higher valuation market cap of Tencent? Possibly, it's all possible, but we can also see a steep fall of it. So I would be very cautiously now. And Nvidia Corporation, I also sold my stock somewhere here, which was a little bit stupid. So I missed like the double, though the next 200% from my entry point. But yeah, you can see Nvidia is now at a point where it's extremely high, overvalued. The new GPUs came out. The problem is you can't purchase them anywhere. So until mid November, December, they're completely sold out. So it's a bit, yeah, I don't know. I'm a bit disappointed by Nvidia, and it has always been one of my favorite companies. So, but now I'm a little bit disappointed that I just cannot purchase one of those GPUs because I want to have a new PC. Yeah. And they in the process of acquiring ARM. ARM is a chip maker from SoftBank. It's part of SoftBank, and let's see how this turns out. Microsoft, so disclaimer, I'm invested in Microsoft. Yeah, new Xbox comes out. Microsoft is doing well with the PC market, not only in the classical software branch, but also when it comes to PC games. So I'm absolutely bullish on Microsoft, but don't buy it only because I talk about it. I mean, it's Microsoft, it's one of the big players. Then we have 11-bit Studios. So 11-bit Studios is a very hyped stock in Germany. And sorry, I would not spend any dollar on 11-bit Studios, in my personal opinion. Totally hyped, so don't buy this. Guys, you're just losing money. You see, it's nicely falling since the 22nd of June. It's nicely falling, and it's also, they don't have so many games. It's like they have the War of Mine and Frostpunk, but I don't expect them to go up again so much. Then we have Sony. I mean, you cannot talk about video games without talking about Sony. Of course, this is the Sony stock. Stop talking, man. So this is the Sony stock. I mean, and if you look at then the max picture, I mean, for Sony, that's important. So we had the hype, of course, in the dot-com bubble. Then it was falling until 2012. And then they also profited of the overall hype at the stock market. And then we have a new entry, and that's a very interesting stock I'm watching now. I consider buying, maybe. It's Unity Software. So everyone knows Unity, so they make the game engines for a lot of games, like the Unreal Engine, but it's Unity, so it's a known game engine, amazing for indie developers. They all use it. So the stock had recently its IPO, and the 18th of September was then trading at $68, and since then 30% up. Oh, sorry, no, not 30%, was going up to $100, so pretty nice. At one point I actually wanted to get in, but they're just climbing 8.44%, that's pretty amazing. And then another stock, and here again disclaimer, there might be a conflict of interest because I'm a shareholder of Corsair Gaming. I just bought this recently. I bought it a little bit here at the up, so they always say don't buy high and sell low. No, I'm not selling it. So I bought the first tranche I was buying here around $21, and I then bought now recently here at $18 a second tranche. So I'm considering when they fall back to the $14 that I'm buying for the third time, and then then it's for the long time. I'm just leaving it there. I love the hardware of Corsair, the RAM. I'm a big Corsair fan, so therefore I bought the stock. Do they have a business model that can't be copied by other companies? No, of course not. I mean, they are hardware maker for PC, but it's still an amazing company. All right, so I want to leave then this overview video here, and I want to tell you again, make sure to comment my Fall Guys video. Make sure to comment this Fall Guys video, because then you can win this game, and it's absolutely legit. Everyone that says something else, don't have to watch my channel, don't have to comment, but it's a big chance to get this amazing game, Fall Guys Ultimate Knockout. So, and of course, comment like this video also, because a next comment picker giveaway video will come for sure. All right, have a wonderful day, guys. See you next time. Bye bye.